Hey everybody! It's Love Pink Lucy! I'm gonna watch. Let me set my iPad on. Okay. Love Pink Lucy is love. Okay, it is 10 to 4, so I'm going to stay on here and try to stay on just an hour. No more than that, because I've got food in the crock pot cooking, and I don't cook anymore, so that's a big deal. I'll wait a few minutes, see if anybody joins me. I haven't done a live page in a while. So, y'all, my desk is a disaster, as always. Made some stuff out of the way over here. Okay. I'm trying to decide what scripture I want to do today. I'm behind in my 100 days of Bible journaling. This last month has kind of been crazy, and I was gone for over a week, and from my house, even though I took my stuff with me, I only got 3 pages done, and so I'm kind of like getting back in the swing of things with that and with my scripture reading and stuff. So anyway, I'm on 80, and I think today is like actually everybody's on like 91, so y'all, I've got some catching up to do, but I'll do it within my own time. God's not worried about that. So, the scripture today, this is about wisdom, and I have an idea of what I want to do, and the one scripture that I put on here, your wisdom is such a treasure. Yes, it is. I think I'm going to actually do, I really like this scripture, Proverbs 2:6. It says, "For the Lord grants wisdom. His every word is a treasure of knowledge and understanding." So, hey guys! Thought I'd jump on here and do a page. This is probably the only time during this week I'll probably get a chance to. So I figured, why not? If I'm gonna do a page, why not do this with my peeps over here? Let's see. I've done, okay, 5. Let's see. "Then you will understand the fear of the Lord and find out." Maybe. And I kind of like Isaiah 26. Hey, Rachel. Isaiah. Sorry. Isaiah 28. I'm sorry. Not 26. 28. Let's see if I have it journaled already. Oh, I don't. 28:29 says, "The eternal commander of heavenly armies is the source of such wisdom. His advice is wonderful." I really like that one. That's a pretty cool scripture. So I think I will do that one. Is the verse, Isaiah 28:29. So I think I'm going to do that. And I'm also going to use some of my stuff. You know, I'm a brand ambassador for Artsy. And so I saw this stamp right here that says, "The sky's the limit." So I want to use that stamp and then say, "Hey, Alyssa, Miss Beach Bum." I'm going to do "The sky's the limit," and then I'll say, "With your wisdom," is what I'm going to do. And I'm going to use this stencil right here with little arrows pointing up. So, that's what I'm going to do. That's the page today. So, oh my gosh, I didn't even prep the page. So, you'll get to see me do that if you've never seen me prep a page before. I think I'm going to do this page. Of course, you do not have to prep your pages. That is just something that I like to do for my own personal way of doing things. But I'm gonna prep my page. Y'all, I take my washi tape and wrap it around, get the sticky off so it doesn't stick fully onto my page right here. Like I said, this is for me, nobody else. I just do it. You start school 7th grade. Okay, Alyssa, I've got I'm super busy this week, but maybe I'll talk to your mom and see if maybe I can come over next week one day and we'll have Bible journal and boot camp. I can't believe you're starting August. Oh my gosh, that's like a month away. What? Where did, like, how do you start school that early? That doesn't seem right. That does not seem right at all. What are y'all doing for the 4th? Are y'all going anywhere? Doing anything? Alyssa? I'm going to be in Columbiana selling fireworks. If y'all want to come get some fireworks and buy some from me. Prepping my page. I'm going to try to do this as fast as I can so I don't waste any time on actual journaling. You don't know what you're doing for the 4th? Well, Daniel and I are going to be down at Insane McCain's fireworks stand. And we're going to be, our friends run it, and so they've asked us to come and help them for the day. So we're going to go down there around 2 o'clock and we'll be there all night. So, y'all know what? I have been to that town, Columbiana, for only a couple of times in my life. Is that crazy? I don't even know much about that town. Haha. So, I'm more of the city girl up here. Okay, my page is prepped with my matte gel medium, in case you're wondering what I just put on there. I have a video on YouTube where you can watch me prep a page and stuff like that. Okay, let me dry it really quick. Clean out the middle. Try this really fast so that we can get going on this page. What's everyone else going to do on the 4th of July? It's kind of weird that it's like happening in the middle of the week, huh? Especially for people that work. It's like a random off day in the middle of the week. Sleep? That sounds like fun. That's what I did yesterday. As soon as I got home from church, I napped. Okay. That's done. I'm going to take some washi tape and I'm going to just put over my scripture. I like to do that on the pages where there is scripture to mask it off. And so that way when I'm through painting, I can peel that back and reveal the scripture. Alright, so I'm going to say on here, of course I'm doing this one. Hold on, let me scoot this over so y'all can see what I'm doing. I've just noticed y'all can't see anything. Y'all can't see what I'm doing. Hopefully I won't drop you in the process. Ah! Is that better? Give me a thumbs up if that's better. Okay. Thank you. Yay. Okay, I'm going to do this stamp that says, the sky's the limit, and then I'm going to freehand with your wisdom. So the sky's the limit with your wisdom. Now, I think I'm going to do just the background like a sky. I'm going to do my watercolors like I usually do. Watercolors are my favorite. Let me draw this a little bit more. They're my favorite for Bible journaling. But I really use just about every medium in my Bible because I have it all. So, but my go-to are my watercolors. Like when I packed my stuff up with me last week when I was away from the house, that's the only thing I took was my watercolors. So I'm going to do the sky. All my little watercolors fell out of their spots. Y'all, these are on sale right now. The Illustrated Faith watercolors are on sale right now. There's a link in my profile if you want to check that out. Just go to my DaySpring affiliate link. Let's see. And they're like some of my favorites to work with. I'm going to get my water brush. I'm going to put some more water in it. Y'all, here's a tip. So my water brush, I took a water bottle and I poked a little hole in the top of it so that I can just literally squeeze my water out into my thing. Into my water brush whenever I need it. I'll do it right here. That way I don't have to run to the bathroom and fill it up. I have everything with me. You do need some, Melissa. These are like creamy and yummy. Like I always tell everybody to start off with, you know, like the cheaper ones from the art store. Decide if you even like to journal with watercolors, and then you can always expand your collection later on. So I want to do the sky. I'm gonna do some blue. Just randomly do some. A little bit indigo going over here. Thank you. Miss ya, girl. Miss ya, miss ya. Okay. I like to do my skies like different colors of blues. Get some more blue over here. So my favorite collection right here, the Jane Davenport Brights. They are my absolute favorite set of watercolors. Okay, I'm keeping an eye on the clock because, you know, Instagram only gives me an hour. And I don't want to go over and y'all not see everything, but we'll see. So I've got 50 minutes to go. Okay. Look at a little bit of green in the sky. Because sometimes the sky has a little green hue. But this really light. Light, light, light. This one's like one of my favorite colors. It's called Mermaid. I use it an awful lot. I get stuck on certain colors and I have to make myself do other things. This a teensy bits of purple. Water that one down a little bit more. See, y'all, it doesn't take a lot of, you don't have to have any artistic ability whatsoever to do what I'm doing on this page. I can promise you that. So don't let it intimidate you. I'm just swishing around some watercolors. You can just do it all one color if you want to. You don't have to add all these different colors that I am, but Okay, how's everyone's summer going? Come on, people, talk to me. What's going on in y'all's lives? Ooh, this blue. Well, of course yours has been good, Alyssa. You've been at the beach for, like, the whole summer. I seriously thought, have they moved down there? Are they ever coming home? I need to go down there and hang out with Donna. For sure. Another set over here. It has different blues in it. And why didn't Ashton go to the beach? Where was she? Oh my word. Again? Y'all need to invite me sometime. Jeez Louisa. Well, if you're going to the beach next week again, then we can't have our Bible journaling boot camp next week. Now, can we? Oh, did she? Okay. I was like, where's Ashton this whole time? That picture your mom posted, like, where she didn't have makeup on and she was all sun-kissed. Oh, she looked so extra pretty. Okay, I think my sky is done as far as color's concerned. I'm gonna dry it and then I'm gonna do something a little bit fun. Now, I'm going to take some white acrylic paint. Gotta go. Okay. Bye, Alyssa. I'll talk to your mom later about coming over. Have fun. Alright. Y'all, that was my little cousin, if y'all were wondering. I'm going to do some white acrylic paint. I'm going to do like little puffy clouds with it. Y'all, I need to seriously go wash out it is super hot. Oh my gosh. I need to wash out some of my little things. All of them, because they're a mess. So I'm going to make like little, do like little puffy things. And I am going, let me see what brush I want to use. I'm going to get, this is actually, not that one. I'm going to use this little brush. You can use whatever. You can use a sponge. Oh, what are you? Oh, that's my cousin, my little cousin. She's like gotten into Bible journaling and I've never like gone down there and like done anything with her and showed her anything. So I've been telling her since she's gotten into it that I was going to come down to her house and show her, you know, hang out with her and we can Bible journal together. So we've been calling it Bible journaling boot camp. So she's been at the beach all just about all summer, so we haven't had a chance to do it. And when I've been busy, they haven't. So so anyway, I'm gonna take this little, but we should do like, it would be fun though if I could do like a Bible journaling day at the church on a Saturday. That's how a lot of people do. They do like workshops. So I should do something like that. Okay, I'm just gonna take this little brush and I'm just gonna kind of do like little puffy, just kind of like, see if I can see that. I'm just taking off some of the extra and I'm just making the sky just kind of have some puffy white in it. I want to put some over where the scripture is, so when I take the tape off, it'll have an extra poof. Let me see it. You can use a brush, you could use a sponge, whatever. You'll be able to see it more when I post a picture of it. I don't think you can see it right now in the lighting as well. Just make these a little bit bigger. And see, you can tell one reason why I do put the tape right here, because that way it protects this page over here. That's the only reason I do that. Okay, that's done. Now I'm going to dry that. I could do them, you know, more, I could add more white to it, but I kind of like it like that. Okay, next, I'm going to take this stencil out of here, my Art C stencil, and see, it has the arrows that are going up. So this is the sky, and sky's the limit, right? So we're going to have arrows pointing up. These stick to the page, so that's cool. All right, so I'm going to do that one. And I think I'm trying to decide what color I should do the arrows. Let me think. Should I do them a dark gray? Let me see what color's over here. And that I have like next to me. I didn't truly plan this out very well. I'm gonna use this I love this color. I'm gonna use this color. Hey, how are you? Okay. Now, I'm going to take this little stencil brush, artsy stencil brush, and I'm just going to dab it in there. Those of you that are about, that like to scrapbook and stuff, you'll probably use stamps, and, I mean, things like this. So, I'm just going to stipple, is what they call it. I'm stippling. My stamp, not stamp, my, oh my gosh, my brain is fried at this moment. What the flip? I'm stippling my stencil. That's the word I'm looking for. Stippling my stencil. Okay. Okay, that's done. Now, let's remove it. Let's see what happened. Oh, super cute. Let's do some on this side too. Why not, right? I mean, come on. Let's just add some more to this. So, y'all, never be afraid. Get messy when you paint. Usually my hands are covered in paint. Okay. Get this paint back out. Here we go. Fun. Stencils are fun. You know, you can make your own stencils too. You can make your own stamps. Yes, I like this color. I'm glad I chose this color. I was going to go with maybe a silver, but I'm liking this teal color better. Okay. That's done. I'll take this off. Voila! Love it! Okay. Let me dry that. If you're just joining me, I am doing, let me read you. Oh my gosh, don't overthink, just do. Just do. I'm doing the scripture that is Isaiah 28:29, and it says, "The Eternal Commander of heavenly armies is the source of such wisdom. His advice is wonderful." And that version is actually the voice. But this is an ESV, so it's a different description on that one. But so anyway, I'm going to then, I'm using this stamp, this artsy stamp, "The Sky's the Limit." And I'm going to put it like right here. I'm going to say "The Sky's the Limit," and then I'm going to put "With Your Wisdom." So with His wisdom, the sky's the limit on anything you can do, right? With His counsel, the possibilities are endless, basically. So I'm going to do that stamp. This is an artsy stamp. This one comes with the stencil set as well. Just FYI, in case you're like, because sometimes people want to know where I got certain things. I'm a brand ambassador for Artsy, but you can get Artsy products at Hobby Lobby has them. So let me get this stamp off here. My little acrylic block going. Okay, I see where I want to put it. I'm going to put it like right. I'll put it right there. Okay. Archival ink is my favorite ink to work with. Ranger Archival ink. I've mentioned this before, but y'all, I was not a stamper until I started Bible journaling. I didn't even own a stamp. I owned like a couple ink pads for some other projects I'd done, but that's it. So I'm gonna put "The Sky's the Limit." What kind of paint is used? Okay. Hold on. What I used for the background, the blue, I used watercolors. You can use any type of watercolors. I specifically used some of the Illustrated Faith watercolor. They're on sale right now on DaySpring. You can, there's a link in my bio for those. It's the, just go to the DaySpring affiliate link. And then I used Jane Davenport watercolors, but you can use any watercolor. It doesn't matter. You can water down acrylic paint and use the same way I just did. These are acrylic paint. I actually just used that for the stamp. You could use ink or paint for that. And then this, I just used archival ink, ink pad. Look at my hands, y'all. This is just doing from this page right here. Love it. Love paint all over my hand. Okay, so next I'm going to write, so "The Sky's the Limit," and then I'm going to put "With Your Wisdom." And I think sometimes I like to paint my lettering, but today I think I'm just going to write it, handwrite it with my marker. I love Faber-Castell Pitt pens, are my favorite, and the one with the bullet nib, I don't know if you can see this, It's my super, super favorite one. And it's like 1.5 is the thing. It's my favorite. And whenever I find them at the store, because sometimes they're hard to find, it's kind of like writing like almost with a Sharpie marker with that type of tip. And it does it. It's not a flexible nib like some of the calligraphy markers are. So I like it. Taking that out. Okay, so I want to say the sky's the limit, and then I'm gonna say let me move some of my junk out of the way. Okay, the sky's the limit. I'm gonna do dot dot dot. This is just my normal handwriting, y'all, pretty much. Just a little bit of flair to it. Other than that, it's my basic handwriting. People ask me where I learned to write, and this is just my normal handwriting. Plus, I've been doing lettering for a long time, because I used to paint Christmas ornaments. And so I had to do a lot of lettering that way. But let me just give you a little secret. There's a website called dafont.com that has all kinds of fonts that you can practice with. A lot of the ladies, some of the ladies in my Bible journaling class that I teach, they get theirs from there. You can just look at it. You can put in a word, like I put the word with, and I want to see how to write it, and it'll give me a gazillion trillion options on how to write that, and I can just copy it by myself. Like, just look at it and copy it. If you're good at that kind of stuff, it's easy to do it that way. Okay, with, sky's the limit, with. Hey, hey, everyone that's joining. Thanks for hanging out with me. Okay, with. I'm just like filling in the lettering a little bit more. I honestly say, y'all just embrace your own handwriting. It's fun to do other types of, you know, lettering and writing and stuff like that. But also learn to love your own handwriting. I'm a big encourager of that. Especially if you're someone who plans on leaving your Bible journals to your children or something like that. I know some people are doing journals for their children. Each one has a journal, a Bible for each child. One day they're going to want to look back and see your own handwriting in it. So I really encourage you. You don't do every page with your own handwriting, but allow there to be some that has your own specific penmanship in it, because that's something that they will really value and cherish, I think. Okay, so the sky's the limit with your wisdom. I know we can always be our harshest critic. Some people are like, oh my gosh, I can't write. I hate my handwriting. But one day you will, your children or whoever will be glad that you did some things in your own writing. Okay. Wisdom. I can hear little feet at my door. If y'all don't know. Exactly, right? Like, I have, hold on, let me dry this a little bit before I put my hand on it. I have some things that were my granny's, and I love her handwriting. And then my mom, like, my mom has, I love her handwriting too. And so, I love seeing things that she's written, and it's just, I don't know, you just cherish it. So I really encourage people to embrace their uniqueness, which even if you don't like your handwriting, it's still unique to you, right? So, wisdom, wisdom, wisdom. Hello, everyone that's joining. I think the next Bible that I have, that I do whenever I decide to start my next one, I'm not going to do like any ephemera, which, what is ephemera, you're wondering? Like, let me see, where's a page that has like some ephemera on it? Like pieces of cardboard, things like that. I'm not going to use anything, and I'm not going to do any more of the tabs because I don't like how it messes up when I'm writing or drawing. So I think the next one I'm just going to do, not going to do that type of stuff. So the bulkiness will just have to come straight from my art or my washi tape. Because you know I love me some washi tape. Okay. So the sky's the limit. I can't believe I'm getting this page done so quickly. I'm actually cooking tonight, y'all. I don't cook hardly ever anymore, like ever. And tonight I'm making some teriyaki chicken in the crock pot with jasmine rice, and it smells so good. My hubs is home. Okay, the sky is the limit with your wisdom. Let's do a little crazy exclamation point right here. Take this off. You did? Oh, I'm jelly. A little bit jelly. A little bit jelly. I always love a good deal. Okay. So next, let's take, this is where I have masked the scripture off. Voila. Then I'm just going to do this, kind of like a little cloud. And I kind of want to, I don't know, kind of decide. I think that I may go through with my white pen, do some highlighting on this. Before I do, let me grab some washi tape, because you know I gotta add some to this page. Let me see here. Which washi do I want to use? Kind of like that one. Ooh, I have arrow washi. Yes, we need arrow. Like, we'll have to do that one, right? We need those little arrows on there. Oh, you're gonna... Girl, you rock with everything you do, so don't underestimate yourself. I've still got to get you to do a piece for the choir room at church. Even though if it's teeny tiny, that's fine. sorry, y'all. I'm getting distracted by all this washi tape. Ooh, these are cute. I've never used that one. We'll use that one. And... No, not that one. I kind of want to do a silver on it. Let me find a silver. There's a silver. Okay, we'll do these three. But first, I'm going to grab my white Signo Uniball. This is the broad tip, if you're wondering. I'm going to go through here, and I'm just going to make, I'm going to just make the lines look like white and black. Just to give a little bit of highlight. Okay, perfect. As long as you got started on it, that makes me happy. Yeah, I did a painting at church at Soak a few weeks ago. I don't know if you were there or not, but I didn't do it like on the stage or nothing. I did it up in the balcony in the dark, and it was so fun. I had so much fun doing that. Hey, this needed this. Okay, I'm gonna polka dot. You know I gotta have some polka dots on here. My goodness. My life is not complete without a polka dot or two. Well, I actually gave them away. Pastor Sims, I told him before the service, I was like, I'm going to be painting during the service. And he was like, okay. And so then, after service got started, Daniel, my hubs, came up to me. He's like, Pastor Sims just told me to tell you that, when you're done, bring him the painting because he wants to, show it to people, and I'm like, okay. I was like, what? Do I have to talk? And Daniel was like, no, he just said he wants you to bring it to him. And I was like, all right. So I actually did two canvases. I did like two 12 by 12s. I had them like as one canvas and I painted them as one and then, took it apart. And so, when I got finished with it, I was in the bathroom. I had run into the bathroom and gotten a heat dryer from the closet and I was drying it so that I'd be ready to go take it to him. And someone comes running in there like, Crystal, Pastor Sims is asking for you from the stage right now. And I'm like upstairs, like furthest away from the stage as possible. So I took off running with the canvas, well, canvases, and take them to him. And he's like on the stage. And then he's like, basically makes me talk from the mic and talk about the paintings and what, prophetic painting is and stuff like that. And but the Lord had told me to give them away, the two pieces. And honestly, I don't even remember what they look like because I painted in the dark and I literally just saw them long enough to dry them and then I gave them away. So I don't even know what they look like. I take pictures of everything I do and this was something I did not get a picture of, so I don't even know. I don't even know what they look like. So it was a pretty cool experience and I hope to do it more often during soak. It was neat, really neat. I got to do it with the MCs also, back before they graduated. I don't know if Nick told you. They took my painting, the painting that I did, and they put it in that local rehab facility. And the day that they took it to hang it or whatever, a lady got saved after one of the MCs explained to her what the painting was and everything. So, oh my gosh, it was so cool just to know. It's like, oh, so humbling. I'm like, I'm gonna cry just talking about it. No, I don't know. I'll add you to the Facebook page that I'm a part of. I've been watching it and just looking into it for a while. And then the Lord started speaking to me about it. Gosh, over a year ago, I did my first piece and, it was just super powerful. And then, I did a piece and gave it to Jeremy, and that's when actually the whole thing started with putting them in the youth, I mean not in the youth, in the choir room. So now we have several pieces in there now. Kind of, sort of, yes. It's, letting the Holy Spirit pour through you into art. I mean, it's different for everybody. For me, I just let the Holy Spirit direct me. I have no clue what I will paint. Sometimes I'll have maybe a little bit of an idea. Like, I've had like a little bit of a vision of something in my mind. But more than likely, I don't know what I'm doing. And the Holy Spirit just paints. Like, He chooses the colors. And I'm just sort of like a vessel. And I don't know what's going to happen on the canvas. It's really a unique experience. But that's how I work. Some people's pieces are a lot different than that. Some are very detailed and, mine are very abstract. So it's just different for everybody. But I'll add you to the group that I'm in on Facebook. Wait a minute, you don't have Facebook, do you? Can't remember. I don't think you did. Okay. I like that. The sky's the limit with your wisdom. usually when you do prophetic art too, you usually give the art away. You don't keep it. I do have two pieces that I have kept for myself that I felt were specifically for me. But, I don't know. It's just a unique thing. So, okay, let me get these arrows. Do some washi. Yeah, no, that it's a Facebook, actual Facebook group. And it's really cool. Like, people share their art in there and they can give you advice and what colors mean and things like that. Which is what's really, really neat, is when you find out like what certain colors mean. That's one thing I think is fun about when, like, painting up there in the dark. I had no clue what I was doing, and then it came together, and I don't know, it was really neat to see what the Lord used. Like, I just take a bunch of my paints with me and just spread them out, and I paint on the floor, like, on my knees on the floor, and it just kind of happens. These are like little bubbles. These are cute. I know some people are like, what is she talking about? Oh, let me do another one. These arrows right here. Some more arrows. Yeah, I'll send it to you. I'll send you the info. Faux shizzle. Let me get some. We need some silver. I'm splitting this washi into. Trying to make it a little bit more funky. This week, I'm so busy. Like, this is the only day I could do this. Tomorrow, I'm painting with my dad. Because, you know, he's an iron. He builds ornamental iron. And so, I will be outside, all day, painting rails for him. Okay, bye girly, see you later. And then 4th of July, I am working on a fireworks stand, and then I bought paint to paint my living room, and that is happening on Thursday. Okay, last but not least, we'll put the date, and I'm gonna use my big old honking mega stamper here. Let me set it to July. It's July the 2nd. Oh my gosh, how is it July? How? Oh my goodness. I have to use my shirt because it's so hard to move this thing. Okay. Alright, July 2nd. I'm going to put the stamp up here. I love my mega stamper. Alright. Beautiful. There's that. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to write. This is day 80. In here. Sometimes, y'all, I actually use Sharpie pens when I do my little bit of writing on here. So this is day 80. Let me make sure it's right at 80. Okay. This is 80 of 100 days of Bible promises. And then this scripture is Isaiah 28. Okay, it's done. Voila. Thanks for hanging out with me, guys. I had fun. I'll post this later for everyone that's going to miss it after it's not live anymore for 24 hours. It will be up on my YouTube channel later this week if you want to go back and see what else, whatever I did or rewatch or whatever, and see the products that I named. So, thanks for hanging out with me, and you guys have a wonderful rest of the week, and happy 4th of July!